Dan.
Yo, CJ, where you at? Yo, you know what time it is? It's time to go. It's time to work. Let's go. All
right.
Get up. Now.
I'm coming. All right.
A real man in the dark when nobody's watching, he putting in work. A real man when coach ain't even watching, he's studying film on his own. Cause he loves the process. If you will be a champion, if you will be a beast, you're gonna have to go through something. And 1, 2, 3.
Be phenomenal, be forgotten.
1, 2, 3.
Be phenomenal, be forgotten.
Last time, 1, 2, 3.
Be phenomenal, be forgotten.
That's my time. Talking dollar with my goal, yeah. We gon' run around the globe, yeah. You gon' want that home, yeah. Kawasaki on the road, yeah.
Yeah.
See me fall, Stephen Curry, how I ball. Garments and a white three on my body. I'm an icon, man. And my girl about a 10. I should win a Benz. City run my hometown, I don't know how I'm a prince here, man. Talk about his checks.
Cash, rack, bills, math, stacks, ew, I'm in.
Love,
with my squad. Oh my
god. Wanna see me fall, I even focus on the door. I don't really give a damn what they talking about. I ranked up, all they girls are doing low. Winning, we just kept it low. Supermodels in the band, oh, is it anywhere that we can't go, man?
Need your girl to the club, yeah. You know I don't give a fuck, yeah. Throwing money at the night shift out in BK on a weekday, man. I got friends moving packs, man. Judging, trying to stack,
no.
Gotta tell me what she into. I'm a freak girl, I could teach you, oh.
You my own Rashida Jones,
yeah. I'm fly.
When I first met Christopher Parrish, it was January 7th, 2000. It was some very emotional feelings for me as a mom. I didn't know what to expect. Being a mother is a lot of responsibility. So I'm like, oh God, I got a little boy here. What am I going to do? Thank God I had an amazing companion at that moment. We wasn't married then. But I knew that he was going to be the best father he could possibly be, because he wanted this child a little bit more than me, because I was not ready. Clearly was not ready, but that little booger here, he 18.
I found out that she was pregnant, and I actually was able to hold my son. I knew it was just a blessing from God. And I'll never forget just laying in the hospital with him, holding him, laying in the bed with him. I knew he was something special.
Character-wise, CJ, growing up, you know, every parent want to, you know, talk about how great their child is. Every parent want to, you know, say, you know, their child is the best. But when I say this about CJ, I truly can say that my son probably was one of the best kids growing up that I ever seen, just experience as being around youth.
He was that quiet kid. Everybody knew CJ, and I think they more or less knew CJ for football. He was very athletic. He was a humble kid. Such a humble kid.
He was
kid.
So humble. He always put others before himself. I remember times when he was in growing up in grade school, and it was about around, you know, fifth, sixth grade. You know, we would buy him all the newest sneaks and everything, and he came home one day, and that's when I knew what kind of special kid he was. And he just like, Dad, you know, I got this kid at school that, you know, he can't have, you know, can't buy sneakers, or his family can't afford the sneakers. And he actually asked us, the sneakers we just bought him, he said, can I take him to school and actually, you know, again, give them to this kid? Because he didn't want the kid to have to worry about people teasing him about his shoes. So he was willing to give up his brand new, I think it was a pair of Jordans that I had bought him, or KD's, one of them. And he was willing to give them up to give to another person. And that's how I knew that he was a very special kid that put others.
I knew when himself. I gave birth to that boy, he was going to do unbelievable things. the first thing that his dad put in his hand when he was, I want to say 3-4 hours on earth into this world, his dad handed him a football.
I knew my son would be an athlete when he was old enough to be able to throw a ball. I never remember, I gave him his first ball and I put in his hand. I was like, you know, hey, you know, you tell your kids, throw the ball. He threw it so hard that I was like, you know, this is not natural. Like, for a kid to be able to throw a ball at 2 years old, he was throwing a baseball like as if he was like 6 or 7 years old. He was already advanced at 2 before he was able to swing a bat, before he was able to, he was doing down, set, go when he was on his knees. If I say ready, set, he'd be on his knees and he'd just scoot across the floor. And just, he already knew, he understood the language of football. He understood the language of baseball at a very young age. And I just couldn't understand how was he picking it up. And that's when I knew he was going to be a really good athlete.
At that moment, he was definitely going to be an athlete. And granted, CJ's an athlete all the way around. Anything you put that kid in, he destroys. He dominates. From wrestling to baseball. I mean, we even had him playing soccer when he was in midgets. And he dominated. So he's definitely 100%, hands down.
I remember his first year of football. And he was, his coach, he had a coach named Bill Knight. And, you know, on that team, he had a kid on that team. That actually was like the beast. Never forget his name. His name was Ron Thomas. And this kid was lighting kids up. I mean, and every kid was scared to hit with him. Even my son. And he cried and he cried and he cried. And he was, I said, CJ, I looked at him and I said, son, I said, look, that kid is no bigger than you. It's no different than
good
you.
Work.
And I'll never forget that kid hit him.
I see. Come on, Jamal.
And he was able to take the hit. It completely changed the game for him when it comes to football. It became a kid that didn't know if he had it to a kid where his name started becoming Hit Stick because he just became this ultimate, like, 5-6-year-old kid that was able just to rock with any kid. And that's when I knew. I said, okay, and he got it.
But I will say this. When he got close to, you know, coming up to his senior year, it did get a little shaky for me as far as, like, college and, you know, all the criteria. Everybody saying that he needed to be this. He's not tall enough. He wasn't big enough. So a little doubt began to sit in.
His senior year of midget football was, he went from being a starter all his life to being a B team player. And I seen something in him that actually turned around and made him, I guess it was like a switch for him. It humbled him. It humbled him to the point where he realized that, you know, a lot of people counted him out as being small. A lot of people counted him out as not being fast enough. And I think the biggest turning point is for my son is that I remember when he transferred from Byron High School. He transferred for, you know, academic reasons. He went to St. Joe's High School. And I remember him going to that school and no one knew who he was. No one recruited him. No one knew that he was an athlete. And I remember him getting the opportunity to play his first game as a high school varsity player against St. Augustine Prep. And the coaches gave him an opportunity to play. And I remember him going on that field. And from that point was a pivotal point in his life where I realized that he is a complete animal when it comes to football. And he wasn't going to let size or speed or anything to deter him from being who he is.
Last 3-4 months of this whole, you know, recruiting, scouting, all this college stuff, Chris told us as we were touring a school, I think it was Del Valle, one of those schools, and they showed so much interest in him. And at the end of the recruiting process, I turned around and I looked at Chris. I said, Chris, look at what these people want to do for you. And he said, Mom, he said, I'm not D2. I'm not D3. Mom, I'm D1. And I'm like, Chris, but these people are offering you so much. What makes, you know, what, like, all these D's, what is it for? He said, Mom, I'm D1. As a mother, I was in doubt. But my son stood firm. He knew what he wanted. He didn't let me, James, or nobody else, no coaches, no friends deter him from what it is that he wanted. And he proved to everybody, he D1. NAU, here he come, D1.
After his sophomore year playing football, he had a real good year at St. Joe's, but it was a basic year. It was nothing outstanding. He just did his job, did what the coaches asked him. After that, I was introduced to an organization by a friend of mine's. The organization was called NLG, which is stand for Next Level Greats. And it's a 7-on-7 competitive play. Not only that, they take the kids around to different colleges. And he actually was able to compete on a 7-on-7 tournament through this organization. And I'm telling you, he was introduced to the top athletes in the nation. And by being in that organization, his speed got faster. His game speed was faster. His ability to read plays got faster. His abilities to defend top-notch receivers got better, to the point where that following year, after being in NLG for a whole year and being exposed to that much talent, being exposed to that much competition, the next year he had a breakout season. His junior year, he was one of the top D-backs in the state. He did some things that I was just, as a father, I was completely shocked, because I was good in sports, but I was never as good as what my son is right now.
I'm dealing with Eddie Williams and AP. So many people have pushed, poured into him and have pushed him to be where he is today.
My son decided that he didn't want to do it anymore, but had a plan. And can tell me why, and can tell me what is he going to do now. And since you're not going to play football, you're not, you're giving up everything that you've been doing all your life. I just need to know that you have a plan. And that's my main focus, is that he has a plan. And really, honestly, even though he's going to NAU and he's going to play football, I'm really more excited and can't wait to see him walk across the stage with a degree. That's what I'm more excited about than anything else.
CJ decides to not want to play for any, for same reason, or if you get injured, it would definitely be devastating. However, education is the number one key. Granted, you play football hoping to get scholarships, to pay for that education. My ultimate goal is Christopher getting a degree and earning his keep for life, because I don't want to be that parent that sent my son to college and he can't get a job. It's sad to say that kind of happens, but the ultimate goal is for Christopher to get his health science degree and become the best trainer or the best whatever it is that he possibly can be and be able to take care of himself. My son, that's his hopes and dreams for that big day of the NFL draft. As a mother, I will feel as though that everything that he has put his 100% hard time, sweat, and bullet tears into, God has blessed him with the ultimate outcome. And as a mom, I will be ecstatic. I will be overwhelmed with joy. That day, I will make sure that my jersey is bedazzled to the brim.
It was really solidify and validate how powerful really God is. And I'm only saying that because all my son's life, all his life, he's always had to prove himself to people. He always had to be second, and he always had to work harder than the next person had to work. Some people are born with crazy speed. Some kids are born with all the height, all the size. All his life, he's been overlooked. All his life, he's been undersized. And for him to make it to that level when so many people didn't think that he had what it takes to get to that level will really validate to me how powerful God was in his life. I know how powerful God was for me, but just to show my son that, I think that would be probably the best moment in my life, because I know that's his dream. But as a parent, we got to be real with ourselves sometime and understand the odds of that happening is very, very slim for a lot of these athletes out here. So for that to happen, I think that would be a personal thing for my son that would just, it would just give me so much joy inside, because I know how bad he wants to get to that level. I know how bad he wants to show people that he has what
it takes. The sky is the limit. Endless opportunities. Look out into that ocean. It's nothing but dreams and opportunities waiting for you. Now go get it. Go get it. Leave nothing in the tank. Go get it.
CJ, I've always said, you've heard me say it a million times, good things happen to good people. And if you continue to work the way you've done here for the last 3 years, you're going to be fine. I'm going to miss you. And, you know, I'm hoping to get to see you play someday. And I'm hoping you'll come back and watch us.
I want to give a really special thanks, though, to just, you know, St. Joe's. St. Joe's Hamilton, Coach Sacco and Coach Rick, you know, Coach Newber. A lot of those coaches there, you know, have really poured into my son. You know, the athletic director that came in, she came in on CJ's junior year, Miss Mercado, and they took my son in like it was family. I mean, they took him in and not even knew anything about him and taught him a lot of things. Not only just taught him, just see, St. Joe's gave him more than just athlete, you know, athletics. You know, St. Joe's gave him the ability to actually step into manhood and taught him, you know, how to be a man and how to fight adversity. So, you know, without going through, you know, a whole lot and missing anyone, you know, all my family, everybody who's really believed in him and never gave up on him. But I'm telling you, I really must say that the St. Joe family, the entire St. Joe family, all the fans, parents, you know, it was a phenomenal experience. I'm going to miss it. I'm going to miss it.
Well, it was kind of funny. I remember him. We were playing down in Vineland. He was a freshman, I think. And what happened was he got in at the end of the game. It was a game that, you know, we kind of ran away with it the first half. And I just remember him coming up and diving at one of our running backs and tackling him. And that's what I remember the most about him, that he was just a fiery little kid and a very aggressive little kid. You know, as a freshman, he's pretty much a self-made player. You know, we tried to guide him the best we can. And, you know, I look at when he came in, he was probably about 128 pounds, if that. And now I look at him, he's close to 190 pounds. And I think that's a credit to him and his family making the commitment to get him here for weight training all the time, because, you know, he's very dedicated. You know, I tell all the kids the same thing. I think that if he continues to work the way he is, and I know it's much different in college because there's just so many players and it's such a business anymore, but, you know, he came a long way from his sophomore year. I can remember in this state game up at Rowan College his sophomore year, we had him at like a defensive end at one point, and he was probably about 148 pounds at that time. And he just progressively got better. You know, he knew what he had to do in the off season. So, you know, that's important. He knows everything he needs to do in the classroom, to discipline himself, to be in the weight room, to be the best he can be.
I'm going to miss it big time. Son, you know Dad love you. Very hard on you. The reason why I'm hard on you is because I don't ever want you to look at life in a sense of that anybody owes you anything. And sometimes in life, you know, some things people, you know, are given, some things are earned, and some things I always tell you in life you have to take. And so, son, just never be a chameleon. Never be a chameleon. You know, I've been teaching you this since you was old enough to understand what a chameleon is. Never just blend in. Never be satisfied with the status quo. Always put God first, no matter what.
Chris, it's mommy. You know that I love you. Only thing I want you to do is to continue to put God first in everything you do. You don't go away and let no one change you. You've been given the tools for life. You've been given guidance. And I just want you to remember, you continue to put Him first, and He'll guide you and lead you in everything, in every situation possible. Just know that Mommy and Daddy is always here for you. We're your biggest cheerleaders, and we're your number one supporters. I love you, and continue to be blessed, and make me proud.
Let's go, C! Hey. 2018 graduate boy, what's up, boy? Let's get it! Let's go! St. Joe, baby, let's go!
St. Joe's number one!
Let's go! Somebody call animal control, because there's a wildcat! That 190. That's that 190 right there. Yeah. That's that 190. Y'all best believe. Hey, watch out. Y'all remember, hey, see, they better tell him, DK, baby, what DK sign?
Oh, my.
How are we doing, C? Yeah. We like that?
Hey.
Hey, that's that DK.
DK. Yeah. Dark Knight.
Dark Knight, baby. Dark Knight.
Oh. Let's go, C.
They wish and I wish and I wish and I wish and I wish and on me. Yeah. I've been moving calm, don't start no trouble with me. Trying to keep it peaceful is a struggle for me. Don't pull up at 6 a.m. to cuddle with me. You know how I like it when you loving on me. I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me. They gon' tell the story was different with me. God's plan. God's plan. I hold back, sometimes I won't, yeah. I feel good, sometimes I don't, like, yeah. I finesse down Western Road, like, next. Might go down to G-O-D, yeah. I go hard on Southside G, yeah, wait. I make sure that Northside E, but still. Bad things, it's a lot of bad things that they wish and 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 on me. Bad things, it's a lot of bad things that they wish and they wish and they wish.
Let's go!
Championship, baby! Championship, baby!
She say, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my bed and my mom, I'm sorry. 50 dub, I even got it tatted on me. 81, they'll bring the crashers to the party. And you know me, turn the 02 into the 03, dawg. Without 40 Ollie, there be no me. Imagine if I never met the broskies. God's plan, God's plan. I can't do this on my own, ayy, nope. Someone watching it close, yup, yeah, close. I've been me since Scarlet Road, ayy, road, ayy. Might go down as G-O-D, yeah, wait. I go hard on Southside G,
let me get that, wait.
I make sure that Northside E, yeah.
Do something short.
And still.
There it is.
Bad
there
things.
It is.
It's a lot of bad things that they wish and 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 on me. Yeah. Yeah. Bad things. It's a lot of bad things that they wish and 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 on me. Yeah.
Won't you please be my God and give me peace of mind? Give me peace of mind.
Peace of mind.
Give me the Lord.
Oh, when
God calls home an angel,
He opens up heaven's door.
Oh, God calls.
On to your word.
Oh.